Now let's talk briefly about tracking code customizations. There are many customizations that you can make to the tracking code, and it's really, really powerful feature to alter the data that is collected on a code level. But this is a little bit of an overkill for a basic installations. But I want to touch on three very important points here that I see are made often as mistakes. And please pay attention. They might not be very relevant to the account that you are setting up, but if you ever have a client who maybe has more than one page, then there might be cross-domain tracking required. If your site is being set up in European countries, you might want to turn on anonymize IP. And if you're interested in getting very good data on demographics such as age or interest, you might want to alter the code to include demographics and interest data. So let's take a look on how this would be set up. First up, cross-domain tracking. What does cross-domain tracking mean? This is a website of one of my old clients. Once you are on his page, he has a lot of content on his page, but he also has a premium button here. And once you click that, you go over to a completely different domain, but we want to be able to track that within Google Analytics account. And so we installed cross-domain tracking on this page. And we can see that it's installed because we have this parameter in the back here, which tells us that the session was transferred. And if you don't have cross-domain tracking set up on this page, Google wouldn't recognize this user as just clicked on from the main page to this premium page, but rather as two different users, which can mess up the whole analysis that we do in the back end, because we won't be able to identify, for example, the source that the user came from when he came to this page and maybe bought something. So it's very advisable to set up cross-domain tracking in this case. So if you have a client that has multiple domains and you want to track this in one Google Analytics account, you need to set up cross-domain tracking. And this is really a customization of the code. So beneath the Google Analytics code, you would add these following parameters. So the sites are actually linked. When you are in Google Tag Manager, you have the configurations within the tag. So under More Settings, you have cross-domain tracking, and you'll be able to configure cross-domain tracking at this point. So please check that out if this applies to your client. Next up, anonymize IP. Anonymize IP is a feature that Google introduced in 2010 because there were some privacy concerns surrounding Google Analytics. Basically, what it will do is anonymize the last part of the IP, so Google won't be able to go back and identify the user based on the IP. We can see that data in Google Analytics anyways, but for companies that are set up within the European Union, they might want to enable this feature to avoid any legal trouble with the use of Google Analytics. And it's pretty easy to do. All you need to do is append this little line to your Google Analytics code, and it will anonymize the IP. Lastly, let's talk about demographics and interests. Now, demographics and interests is a report within Google Analytics. So if you go to the reporting tab, you'll find under audience and demographics that you can enable that to see very awesome data such as the category or the age group or the gender of who is visiting your site. Now this works through double-click data that Google has gathered, and it requires you to change your Google Analytics code. So first of all, you need to enable that. We'll click here on enable within the reporting view, and then you need to change the Google Analytics tracking installation. So this is one time, one code to change. So I can look that up here in this help section. right here, we just need to add this line of code to our whole Google Analytics script, require display features. I would recommend to turn this on for any client, only if he doesn't want his data to be surveyed and taken into consideration for finding out these demographic features, you might want to leave that out as a customization for your tracking installation.